Lars Howlettt recently visited Punahou as a spirit and service speaker to help Punahou create its very own labyrinth. Punavision was there to learn more about these structures and how they are designed.
Well, I was really fortunate to have the chaplains and the people from the Luke Center at my workshop last summer, and they told me about the theme of journey this year, and that they were really interested in creating a labyrinth on a canvas that they had purchased. So they invited me here to speak in chapel about a personal journey that I was on through the labyrinth, and then also to help the students to create a canvas labyrinth of their own to keep. So it's been a great opportunity to talk about labyrinths, but even more so to just put them out on different places in the campus so that, you know, I just did the geometry class and did a lecture, but then I walked out of the geometry class and there were seven students walking the labyrinth and experiencing it on their own. The thing about a labyrinth is to experience your own experience. So I can tell you what it was like for me to walk the labyrinth and what I used it for in my life, but you know, many people use it for different things, so it's important for people to go out and see how it feels for them. And so I tried to put labyrinths in as many different places around campus so that people could just happen upon them and do them without anybody watching or no one saying this is how it is. You know, it just allows them to discover it for themselves. I just got out of a geometry class where we taught labyrinth seed patterns to people, and if you draw the seed pattern and you connect the dots and the lines together, you can draw the seven circuit classical labyrinth, which is one of the oldest, maybe 4,000 to 6,000 years old. And so by learning the seed patterns, you can learn how to draw the labyrinth. And you can make labyrinths just, you know, to trace with your finger as a visual meditation, or you can make them, you know, on the sand or on the floor, you know, for walking. The labyrinths are sacred space, and when you create a labyrinth, you're creating a kind of an energy field. And so we walked around campus looking for spaces that were contained, that had a sense of being held, because the labyrinth holds you within the space. And so we did one in the palm grove here, and there were already a circle of palms that I put a small labyrinth in the middle, and then we had a big tree, and we thought, well, wouldn't it be nice to have a giant labyrinth around a tree so that when you were walking, you were held underneath the branches. I hope the labyrinth gives the students of Punahou an opportunity to take time in space that they otherwise wouldn't have. And so, you know, here in school, you're often going from one thing to the other. You know, we have these schedules, and if you have the labyrinth, it's an opportunity to kind of step out of the schedule and just take a moment to kind of be in the present and not worry about the homework or the grade or the graduation, but just to be here on this beautiful campus, you know, at this time, and just to check in and see how you're doing. And, you know, it's an invitation. The labyrinth is an invitation to find out more about their own life journey.